गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रेन,
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स इन द प्रीवियस पीरियड एंड वी लर्नड अबाउट द सेल वॉल एंड सेल मेम्ब्रेन फाउंड इन यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनल्स scattered within the cytoplasm or the different cell organelles. You know that cell organelles are minute organs which are scattered within the cytoplasm and each one is assigned a particular function. It's because of all these cell organelles that a cell is able to exist as a functional unit. So one by one we'll learn the different cell organelles present in the cell. We'll start with the endomembrane system. Some organelles with coordinated functions together constitute the endomembrane system, a group of organelles. So they are having some coordinated functions or their functions are interrelated. So those organelles together form the endomembrane system, and the organelles included under endomembrane system are endoplasmic reticulum, abbreviated as ER, Golgi complex, lysosomes, and vacuoles. These are the four organelles that form the endomembrane system. Once again, endomembrane system consists of a group of organelles that have coordinated functions or they have some interconnected or interrelated functions, and the different organelles included under endomembrane system are endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes and vacuoles. So first we will learn about these four organelles, starting with the first one, endoplasmic reticulum. In class 9 you had learned about endoplasmic reticulum. I don't know whether you are remembering. Yes, previous slide. No, Aditya Dev. Okay, are you remembering children what you had learned about endoplasmic reticulum? Anything are you remembering? Any one point? Types of endoplasmic reticulum, their functions. What are the two types of endoplasmic reticulum?
Smooth and rough.
Smooth and rough endoplasmic reticulum. What makes the endoplasmic reticulum rough? Why one is smooth and the other one is rough? Not remembering. What is making the surface of one endoplasmic reticulum, one type of endoplasmic reticulum rough and the other one smooth? I'll give you a clue. We already discussed about those structures. They are the sites of protein synthesis. What are they? Which organelles are known as the site of protein synthesis found in both eukaryotic and prokaryotic cells? Non-membrane bound.
Ribosomes.
Ribosomes. Ribosomes are found attached to the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum. So that makes its surface rough. Even if you are sprinkling some, maybe a smooth surface, and you sprinkle some sand over there, and then you try to feel the surface, it will be very rough. So same way, when ribosomes are scattered on the surface, it will give it a rough appearance, and hence we call it as RER or rough endoplasmic reticulum. On the other hand, endoplasmic reticulum can be without ribosomes also. So when ribosomes are not there, the surface will be very smooth. Then you call it as SER or smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And rough endoplasmic reticulum will help in the production of rough ribosomes are there. So they will help in the production of proteins, because ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis. So rough endoplasmic reticulum will produce proteins and smooth endoplasmic reticulum will produce lipids. Lipids are produced by smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the rough one will produce proteins. And some of the proteins and lipids they are producing will be used for membrane biogenesis. I told you to read class 9 textbook or this particular chapter. I don't know how many of you read. Membrane biogenesis. Can you guess? You had learned in 9, but now since you have forgotten, can you guess from the term what is membrane, bio, genesis? Genesis means what? Genesis. Spermatogenesis. Oogenesis. Embryogenesis. Genesis. Don't know? Formation. Genesis is formation. Okay? So membrane biogenesis, synthesis of membrane. Plasma membrane is made up of what, children? We learned the last period. Plasma membrane is made up of fluid mosaic model. Plasma membrane is made up of
proteins and lipids.
Proteins and lipids. And some of the proteins and lipids produced by this rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum will be used up for synthesizing the cell membrane or plasma membrane. And you call the processes membrane biogenesis. I don't think it is given in 11th standard textbook, but you had learned about membrane biogenesis in class 9. And some of the proteins and lipids, they function as hormones, enzymes, etc. Okay, let us learn about endoplasmic reticulum. Reticulum. The word meaning is network. Reticulum of tiny tubular structures. Now coming to the structure of endoplasmic reticulum. So these are, or these constitute tubular structures. Tiny, tiny or very minute or very small tubular structures. And you can see them scattered in the cytoplasm. You can see them even attached to the or very closely associated with the nucleus or freely scattered. Endoplasmic reticulum will divide the intracellular space into luminal space and extraluminal compartments. Luminal and extraluminal space or compartments. Intra means inside. Intracellular. The space within the cell can be divided into two compartments. Those present within the endoplasmic reticulum. I told you these are tubular structures. So that space within the endoplasmic reticulum will form luminal, and those which are outside that form extraluminar compartments. So once again, endoplasmic reticulum consists of a network of minute tubular structures which are scattered in the cytoplasm. And this endoplasmic reticulum will divide the entire space within the cell into two compartments. Intra means inside. Inter means in between. So the space within the cell will be divided into two compartments by means of this endoplasmic reticulum. So the space occupied within the endoplasmic reticulum, you call it as luminal space, and those outside the endoplasmic reticulum, you call it as extraluminal space or compartments. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. You had already learned this in class 9. Rough endoplasmic reticulum. Here you can see both ribosomes are attached to rough endoplasmic reticulum. So rough endoplasmic reticulum is called so because its surface is rough because of the presence of ribosomes. On the other hand, you can find smooth ones with no ribosomes attached to it, so that it will be having a very smooth appearance. The surface will be very smooth. So endoplasmic reticulum are of two types, rough and smooth. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has got ribosomes attached to it. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, their ribosomes will be absent. So hope you have understood these three points about its structure and the types. It consists of a network. As you can see, they are forming a network of tubular, minute tubular structures. These can be scattered in the cytoplasm, and these structures scattered in the cytoplasm will divide the space within the cell into two compartments. Those within the endoplasmic reticulum, you call it as luminal compartment, and those outside, extraluminal compartment. And there are two types, rough and smooth. Rough has got ribosomes attached to it, making its surface rough. Whereas on the other hand, smooth endoplasmic reticulum has got no such structures present. Thereby, its surface will be smooth. Functions. RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum, is found in cells which are involved in protein synthesis and secretion. They play an important role in the synthesis of proteins and secretion. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, so that is a site for synthesis of lipids. In animal cells, lipid-like steroid hormones are synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So steroid hormones, the synthesis of steroid hormones, because they contain lipids. So these steroid hormones are also synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So many functions apart from this, you had learned many functions about endoplasmic reticulum in class 9. Are you remembering any of those? Anything you need to add? Apart from this, do you remember any other points which you had learned, or any other functions of endoplasmic reticulum? Nobody is remembering. Once again, a rough endoplasmic reticulum helps in the synthesis of proteins and secretion, or they are found in cells which are involved in protein synthesis and secretion. A smooth endoplasmic reticulum will help in lipid synthesis, and in animal cells, the steroid hormones with lipids are synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Many more functions are there. One is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum found in vertebrate liver cells. It will help in detoxifying poisonous drugs. It plays an important role. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum found in vertebrate liver cells play an important role in detoxification of poisonous substances. Then endoplasmic reticulum forms a framework for different biochemical activities, a site where different biochemical activities can take place. Then it also helps in the transport of materials, so they act as channels for the transport of materials between the nucleus and cytoplasm, or between different parts of the cytoplasm. Okay, you want me to repeat? These are the three points which you have to learn this year. These are the three points mentioned in your textbook. Rough endoplasmic reticulum involved in protein synthesis and secretion. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum in lipid synthesis. And steroid hormones are synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And I had added a few more points. One is smooth endoplasmic reticulum present in vertebrate liver cells. In the liver cells of vertebrates, they can help in detoxifying poisons and drugs. Okay. Then the next point is that it acts as a framework, a cytoplasmic framework, means a framework present in the cytoplasm which provides a surface for different biochemical activities, or it provides a surface for carrying out different biochemical activities. Then the next point that I mentioned was it acts as channels to transport materials between nucleus and cytoplasm, or between different parts of the cytoplasm. So those are some of the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Any doubts? Do you have any doubts with endoplasmic reticulum? Any point you want me to repeat, you can tell. Aditya Dev, have you completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now next, we are going to learn about Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex. Anybody is remembering any points about at least the name of the scientist? No. Reticular structure. This is also forming a network consisting of many flat disc-shaped sacs or cisternae. You can see in the figure, disc-shaped, flattened disc-shaped structures, you call it the cisternae. The diameter ranges between 0.5 mm to 1 mm. And these are stacked, these are arranged one above the other parallelly, a parallel arrangement. If you observe the figure, you can make out they are arranged parallelly one above the other. They are stacked. They are arranged one above the other. It's a reticular structure and it comprises of flattened disc-shaped sacs and you call them as cisternae. And these are arranged one above the other parallelly. And this organelle was first observed by the scientist Camillo Golgi in 1898. And therefore, the organelle got the name Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex. Now the cisternae, you can see how cisternae are arranged. The cisternae are concentrically arranged near the nucleus. You know what is meant by concentric arrangement? I'll show the previous slide. See, concentrically arranged. Isn't this concentric arrangement? Math students? Yes or no? Okay. So they are concentrically arranged. So these cisternae, as you can see, these are concentrically arranged. Those who have missed out the previous slide, I will show it again. See, they are concentrically arranged near the nucleus. Cisternae has got two distinct faces. So these are having two distinct faces. One face is the convex face or the cis face or forming face. You can call it as cis or forming face, convex. So because of the shape, you call it as convex and the other side is concave. One is convex face, the other one is concave. And the convex face, you can even call it as cis or the forming face. And the other side is concave, trans or maturing face. Forming face is cis and maturing face is trans. And cis and trans, these two are Latin words. Cis means on this side. Trans means on the other side. So the meaning of cis and trans is very simple. One side and the other side. Cis means on this side. Trans means on the other side. That is a word meaning of cis and trans. So as you can see in the picture, see, this is the cis face and the other side is trans face. And cis face is a forming face. Formation is taking place on the cis face and here it is maturing phase. Trans phase is maturing phase. And why it is called, so we will learn. So cisternae, they are having two distinct faces, convex, cis or forming phase, and concave, trans or maturing phase. Cis and trans phases are entirely different. So these phases, they are different, but they are interconnected or interrelated. We'll come to that. All the points about Golgi apparatus we'll see. First, let us see more about cis and trans phase. Now, why one is known as forming phase and the other one is maturing phase? Materials, you know, Golgi apparatus, one important function is a packaging of products in vesicles. That also in class 9 you had learned, it will help in packaging of products in vesicles, transportation, etc. So materials which have to be packed in the form of vesicles means small bag-like structures. Word meaning is sac-like or bag-like structures. So materials which need to be packed in the form of vesicles from the endoplasmic reticulum. Children, I told you in the beginning, four organelles. We commonly call it as endomembrane system because they are having coordinated function. Their functions are interrelated. And here, the materials being released from the endoplasmic reticulum, you can see in the figure, this is endoplasmic reticulum. So the material, see here, you can see the materials which are released from the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, they will be fusing with the cis phase. Okay, and then they'll gradually move towards the trans phase. From cis phase, they will move towards the trans phase. So once it reaches the trans phase, it will get released from there. The vesicles will get released from there. So this will be transferred to the cis phase from the endoplasmic reticulum. From there, they will move towards the trans phase. Trans phase is the maturing phase. The releasing of these substances will take place from the trans phase. Proteins synthesized by ribosomes present on the endoplasmic reticulum, they'll get modified in these cisternae before they are released from this trans phase. So whatever materials from the endoplasmic reticulum, so these are very closely associated and they will fuse with the, so as you can see in the figure, so this is endoplasmic reticulum and here you can see nucleus, and from the endoplasmic reticulum the materials synthesized will fuse with the cis phase, and then once it is here it gets modified. As it moves from the cis phase to the trans phase, so already you had learned in class 9 that it helps in packaging, modification, secretion of products. So it performs all these functions, packaging, dispatching to different targets, modification of the products. All these functions are undertaken by Golgi apparatus. So those substances which are released from the endoplasmic reticulum, they will fuse with the cis phase. And from there, that is why you call it as forming phase. And from there, they will slowly move towards the trans phase. So these materials will undergo modification as it moves towards the trans phase. And once it reaches the trans phase, these will be released outside. These particles will be ready to get transported to other areas. So they'll be released from the trans phase and thereby you call it as forming phase. So once again, I will repeat all the points that we discussed, and hence Golgi apparatus is closely associated with endoplasmic reticulum. We will see all these points about Golgi complex once again. Golgi complex, these are reticular structures. Reticular means forming a network. And it is made up of, or it consists of, flattened disc-shaped structures. See here you can see these are flattened disc-shaped structures. The diameters range from 0.5 mm to 1 mm. And the arrangement, how are these cisternae arranged? They are stacked just like, just like we stack coins one above the other. So similar to that, they are stacked parallelly one above the other. And these organelles were first observed by the scientist Camillo Golgi, and hence the apparatus got the name Golgi apparatus, named after the scientist. And about the arrangement of cisternae, already we learned that these are parallelly arranged one above the other, or else you can say these are concentrically arranged near the nucleus. I showed you what is meant by concentric arrangement. And these cisternae, they are having two distinct phases. So cisternae are stacked one above the other, or they are concentrically arranged, and we can distinguish two phases for this cisternae. One end you call it is cis phase, and the other end you call it is trans phase. Cis phase, that is a convex side, and you call it is forming phase also, because the formation, the products are getting fused with that, formation is beginning there in the cis phase. And as it moves from the cis phase to trans phase, these materials will undergo modification and it will get matured at the trans phase, or it will be released from the trans phase. So one end is convex cyst phase or the forming phase. The other end is concave trans phase or the maturing phase. One end formation is taking place, other end these are getting matured. Cis and trans phases, even though they are entirely different, their functions are interrelated, because those which are fusing with the cis phase only finally coming out through the trans phase. And I told you the word meaning, these two are Latin words, cis and trans. Simply it means on this side and on the other side. Cis means on this side, trans means on the other side, because these are found at two ends or at two opposite regions of this, these cisternae. And how they are closely associated with, it can be asked, why do we say that Golgi apparatus is very closely associated with endoplasmic reticulum? The materials which need to be, just see the figure given, then you will get a better idea. Materials, see the different functions of Golgi apparatus. This is why I told you, you should refer 9th standard textbook. So the different functions include like materials. I will just list out some of the functions of Golgi apparatus, which you had learned in class 9. You can note it down if you don't have a textbook. The materials which are synthesized, the materials which are produced near endoplasmic reticulum are packed and dispatched to different targets, both inside and outside the cell by means of Golgi apparatus. Once again, I will say, the different materials synthesized near endoplasmic reticulum, the different materials which are synthesized near endoplasmic reticulum will be packed and dispatched, means transported. It will be packed, just imagine a factory. Materials are packed and they are transported. So packaging and dispatching of the materials synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum to different targets, to different destinations, both inside and outside the cell, is carried out by Golgi apparatus. Another function is, it will help in storage. Materials will get stored in the Golgi apparatus. Modification, the materials which are stored there will undergo modification. For example, simple sugars can get converted into complex sugars within the Golgi apparatus. So it will help in packaging, modification and storage of products. Okay, it will help in storage, modification and packaging of products in these bag-like structures known as vesicles. You want me to repeat it again? The different additional functions that I told, the different materials which are synthesized near endoplasmic reticulum will be packed and dispatched to different targets, both inside, it can be within the cell or outside the cell, by means of Golgi apparatus. It will help in storage, modification and packaging of products in vesicles. Now you just listen this particular slide. See the slide and listen here. Materials which are to be, like, many materials will be synthesized in the rough endoplasmic and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. For example, proteins and lipids. It should not remain there within the endoplasmic reticulum. You know that some of them are used for synthesizing cell membrane. Membrane biogenesis, I told in the beginning. So if it has to be used for synthesizing cell membrane, it should be transported from the place where they have formed. So for this transportation, we need the assistance of Golgi apparatus. So materials synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum, they'll be packed in the form of vesicles and they will fuse with the cis phase. And then later they'll come out through the trans phase or maturing phase. Proteins synthesized by the ribosomes on the endoplasmic reticulum, they'll undergo modification. So they will fuse with the cis phase, and as they move towards the forming phase or trans phase, it will undergo modification. Some modifications are undergone by these proteins, and once it is completed, it will be released from the trans phase, so that from there it can be transported to different destinations. And that is why we say that Golgi apparatus is closely associated with endoplasmic reticulum. The products in endoplasmic reticulum, different materials synthesized there in the endoplasmic reticulum, if it has to be transported to different targets, the help of Golgi apparatus is needed. We need a transporter. Maybe a company manufactures enough goods, but if it has to, if there is no transporter to take it to different targets, then it is of no use. So it will be synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum, not only endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so one example is in the endoplasmic reticulum, materials are being synthesized, and if it has to reach the different destinations across the cell or outside the cell, we need a transporter. It has to be packed and dispatched properly to those targets. So there comes the role of a Golgi apparatus. Hope you have understood. Have you understood? Any doubt, Aditya Dev? You want to note down any points?
Amen.
Any doubt? Functions. Packaging of materials. It will help in packing materials to be delivered either to the intracellular targets or secreted outside the cell, or else packing materials to be transported both in the cell, to be transported within the cell or outside the cell. As I told you, the materials are packaged for transporting it to different targets within the cell or outside the cell. It is an important site for the formation of glycolipids and glycoproteins. So glycolipids and glycoproteins are also being formed within the Golgi apparatus. Okay. Functions you got?
No.
Okay, write down. Packaging of materials to be delivered either to intracellular targets or extracellular, either to intracellular or extracellular targets. Intracellular means within the cell, extracellular outside the cell. And previously we discussed about their close association with endoplasmic reticulum. That also you can include under functions, or else those functions which I told you already, storage, modification and packaging of products in vesicles. Then what else I said, material synthesized near endoplasmic reticulum will get transported to different targets, both within the cell and outside the cell. That is already mentioned here with the help of Golgi apparatus. Then it will help in the formation of complex sugars. Here it is written, glycoproteins and glycolipids are also formed within the Golgi apparatus. And it will... Yes?
Vesicles.
Small bag-like structures. You can see the picture of vesicles here. Small round bag-like structures. Or sac-like structures. Bag means not like our handbag. Bag-like or sac-like structures. At least in the next class, you do read your 9th standard textbook, children. Okay, quickly recap so that we can wind up. Valentina may begin. Start from endomembrane system. What forms the endomembrane system? Which are the four organelles included?
Endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosomes, and macrophages.
Why do you call it as these four organelles as endomembrane system, Nimida?
Because some organelles with cognitive functions form an endomembrane.
Pardon? These organelles are having some coordinated function, or their functions are interrelated. And then what we learned about endoplasmic reticulum, Emilin?
They are tiny structured, scattered in cytoplasm. They divide into two.
They will divide what into two?
Intracellular space
into two. Which are those two compartments?
luminals and inside and
extra luminal space. Okay, next point, Malavika, we've been the two types of endoplasmic reticulum.
Rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum.
What is the difference between both?
The rough endoplasmic reticulum has ribosomes present on the surface, and they are they synthesize
and smooth
protein.
Okay, and smooth
ribosomes are absent.
Okay, Shabari.
Rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes proteins and smooth synthesizes lipids.
Okay, next point. Devika.
Yes, ma'am. So smooth endoplasmic reticulum is a site for lipid formation, and in animal cells, it also helps in the formation of steroid
hormones. Okay. Continue.
Then, ma'am, smooth endoplasmic reticulum is also, which is present in the vertebrate liver cells, helps in the detoxifying of poisonous substances.
Okay, okay. Malavika, Prabil, then after that, what did we learn?
In endoplasmic reticulum or Golgi apparatus?
We completed all the points, no? Endoplasmic reticulum, now Golgi apparatus.
It was observed by Camillo Golgi.
Okay, then easy point, no? Annelies? Okay, Annelies?
It has flat disc-like structures. Which is called cisternae.
Which are called cisternae. And how are they arranged?
They are parallelly stacked to each other.
Okay. Or else you can even say that they are concentrically arranged near the nucleus. Then, Lakshmi?
And the materials are in the form.
Yes, Lakshmi?
Materials are packed in the form of vesicles, and endoplasmic reticulum fuse with this six phase and move to the transphase
or the forming phase. Maturing phase. So it is having two distinct phases. The cisternae, they are having two distinct phases. One is cis phase and the other one is trans phase. Cis phase is the convex phase, or you call it as the forming phase, whereas the other one, trans one, or the maturation phase, or even you call it as a concave phase. Yes. Then what else? Ellen? Ellen Joshi.
Ma'am, cis and trans are generally different but interconnected.
Even though these two are entirely different, they are interrelated. Then, Sarah?
They help in storage.
What two substances we mentioned will be formed there?
Where?
They help in the formation of dash and dash.
Package and transport.
Formation of dash and dash.
Formation.
Two complex substances,
glycoproteins and
glycolipids. Glycoproteins and glycolipids. Thank you, children. So see you next class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.